This video is going to be about factoring the difference of two perfect squares. So I want to start out by multiplying two binomials together and show you how we get to the problem we're trying to solve. So let's multiply x plus 7 times x minus 7. So we FOIL these. We get x times x will give me an x squared. We're going to get x times negative 7 is negative 7x. Then positive 7 times x is positive 7x. And 7 times negative 7 is negative 49. Now, watch what happens when I simplify this by combining the middle terms. I'm going to get x squared. And the middle terms are the same except for the sign. I've got a negative 7x and a positive 7x. So they're going to cancel each other. They're going to equal 0. And then we're just going to end up with a negative 49. X squared is a perfect square, and 49 is a perfect square. And when we subtract one number from another, we say we have the difference of those numbers. So this is the difference of two squares. And this is a pattern that you're going to see in a number of problems. Teachers, for some reason, love to give this thing as a problem on tests. So what I want to do is give you some problems where we start out with something like this and then realize how we get back to the factored version. Okay? So let's start with the problem. X squared minus 9. And we want to factor that into two binomials. So we know that the first term in each binomial is going to be an x, because we've got an x squared here. Looking at this negative 9, we realize 9 is a perfect square, and there's no middle term. Well, when we have a difference of two perfect squares and no middle term, basically, to solve it, all we have to do is take the square root of the second term now, put a 3 here and a 3 here, make one of these positive and one of them negative. And we can multiply it back just to make sure we're right. So x times x is x squared. X times negative 3 is negative 3x. 3 times x is positive 3x. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. And you can see already that these two are going to cancel. And we'll get x squared minus 9. Okay, let's try a couple more. So let's look at this one. How about 25a squared minus 16? Okay, examining it, we realize that 25 is a perfect square and a squared is a perfect square. So 25a squared is a perfect square. 16 is a perfect square. There's no middle term, and we're taking the difference of those two squares. So really, all we have to do is put in our parentheses, take the square root of the first term, which is 5a, make that the first term of each of our binomials, put in one positive sign, one negative sign, and then take the square root of the second term, which is 4, square root of 16 is 4, and this is going to be our answer, 5a plus 4, 5a minus 4. Notice the pattern of the answers. You've got basically two identical answers, two identical binomials, except that you've got a positive sign in one and a negative sign in the other. Again, we can check this by multiplying it back. 5a times 5a is 25a squared. 5a times negative 4 is negative 20a. 4 times 5a is positive 20a. And 4 times negative 4 is negative 16. These terms in the middle cancel. You're going to get 25a squared minus 16. Okay, one more. So let's take 8a squared minus 18. Okay, now, 8 is not a perfect square, and neither is 18. But before we just decide that we can't do this, let's try simplifying this by factoring out a common factor. Both of these numbers are even. So why don't we try factoring out a 2? Dividing the 8 by 2, I'm going to get a 4. So that'll be 4a squared minus dividing the 18 by 2, I'll get a 9. So now looking at what I have inside parentheses, this is 4a squared, which is a perfect square, and 9, which is a perfect square. So this binomial can be factored. So let's keep our 2 and get our 2 final binomials. So the square root of 4 is 2, and the square root of a squared is a. So I'll have a 2a for both of these, a plus sign and a minus sign. The square root of 9 is 3. So there's my answer. 2 times 2a plus 3 times 2a minus 3. Checking it, I'll multiply these two binomials together first. I have to keep my 2. So 2a times 2a is 4a squared. 2a times negative 3 is negative 6a. 3 times 2a is positive 6a. And 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. I can cross out these two because they cancel each other, negative 6a and positive 6a. And now distributing my 2, I get 8a squared. 2 times negative 9 is negative 18. And that's exactly the same problem I began with. Okay, so this factorization is going to work. Okay, so reviewing the steps. First, to see if you can use this method, see if you have two terms. If they're both perfect squares, then you're ready to go on. If they're not both perfect squares, see if you can divide out, if you can factor out some number which will leave you with two perfect squares. Next thing is make sure that you're dealing with a difference. This sign has to be negative. If it's positive, stop right there. You can't go on. Okay, so you've got two perfect squares. You've got the difference of them. Take the square root of the first one. That's going to be the first term in each of your binomials. Take the square root of the second term. That'll be the second term in each of your binomials. Put a plus sign for one of the binomials, negative sign for the other binomial, and you're done. And that's really all there is to it. Practice a bunch of these. I guarantee you'll see them on tests. Take care. See you next time.